If writing reports is not something you do every day, it might be a bit daunting. How should you structure it? What should be included? There are some basics you should be aware about when it comes to creating a professional report. This includes adding a table of contents to your report, adding page numbers, and properly referencing all of your sources. Let me show you how to do this effectively in Word 2013.
Here's a report that a colleague of mine has written. Even though it looks okay, he hasn't used Word effectively. He's just applied formatting to the headings without using any heading styles. And because of this, Word has no idea about the structure of this document, and it's very hard to navigate. If I go to the View tab and open up the navigation pane, you'll see that it's completely empty.
Hi, I'm so sorry to interrupt. I just wanted to let you know that if you're annoyed by the ads in this video, you can access our tutorials ad-free by getting a subscription to businessproductivity.com or signing up for one of our many courses on platforms such as Udemy, CyberU, and Vimeo On Demand. I also wanted to take this opportunity to tell you a bit more about Storyals. Storyals, which stands for Story-Based Tutorials, is our video package offering for organizations that want to increase employee productivity using Office 365. With Storyals, organizations can inspire, motivate, and educate users on effective use of Office 365 by showcasing real-life best practices. Finally, I want to encourage you to subscribe to our YouTube channels, Business Productivity and Storyals. Here you will also find my video blog, Succeed in the Digital Workplace, as well as other videos that can help you increase your productivity. If you have any questions or comments, please post them here and I'll do my very best to get back to you. With that, let's go back to the tutorial. Thank you for watching.
If I go to the References tab and try to insert a table of contents, I get a message informing me that styles need to be applied. Otherwise, no entries for the table of contents can be found. I'll click Undo to remove the table of contents folder. The first thing I'll do is to add heading styles to the document. To add heading styles, mark the heading you want to apply the style to. I'll start with the title. On the Home tab, right-click the style you want to apply and select Update Title to match selection. This way, the title keeps the current formatting. Next, go to the first level heading. Here, I'll mark the heading by clicking in the margin next to the heading. Instead of marking all of the headings one by one manually, click Select, select text with similar formatting. All text that has the same formatting has now been selected. Now you can apply the heading 1 style. To keep the look and feel of the orange formatted headings, right-click and choose Update Heading 1 to match selection. Now you can see that all the first level headings are visible in the navigation pane, making it easier to navigate. I'll continue to add styles to the rest of the headings. I'll scroll down and mark the bolded text, choose Select Text with Similar Formatting, right-click Heading 2, and choose Update Heading 2 to match selection. I'll do the same thing for the third and final heading. As you can see, as I add the heading styles, the hierarchy in the navigation pane grows. I'll click the arrow to go to the top of the document. Using the navigation pane, I can easily navigate my document. In this paragraph, I can see that my colleague has included information from a report. The website has been added as a hyperlink. It's good that he linked to the source, but in a professional report, you ought to insert source references as footnotes so that more information can be shown and the source more easily verified. To see more information about the source, I'll open up the hyperlink by pressing the Control key on my keyboard and then clicking the link. I'll position the web page to the left on my screen by pressing Windows key arrow left. And then I'll click my document and then press Windows key arrow right. Now I can see the two windows side by side. This works if you're using Windows 7 or later. To insert a footnote, place the mouse cursor after the word or title you want to add the footnote to. Go to the References tab and click Insert Footnote. Now you can write the proper source reference in the footnote. Start with the author. In this case, there are three. I'll copy the authors by marking them and pressing the keyboard shortcut Ctrl+C. Place your marker by the footnote, right-click and select Paste, Keep Text Only. Then add a comma. Next, copy the name of the article and copy and paste in the same way. Make the title italic by marking it and selecting italic in the float bar, or press the keyboard shortcut Ctrl+I. I'll add the name of the publication company, the date, and then finally the web address. Since the internet changes all the time, it's recommended that you include the date you accessed the web page in parentheses at the end. Finally, I'll remove the hyperlink from the text by right-clicking and selecting Remove Hyperlink. Now, I'll close down the web browser and maximize my document window again. In the next sentence, I can see that my colleague has added a reference to a paragraph later in the document called Place Channel. To reference a section in a document properly, mark the name where you want the reference added. On the References tab, click Cross-Reference. In the Reference Type drop-down, select what it is you want to refer to, and in this case, it's a heading. In the Insert Reference To, select what information you want to add to your document. Select the heading name and click Insert. The name of the heading is now inserted as a cross-reference, so that if you change the name of your heading in the document, the name will be updated here as well. You also have a hyperlink embedded in the reference, so that the reader can easily go to that section. In order to help readers that read the report on paper, it's good to add the page number as well. Add the text on page, and then click cross-reference again. Change the insert reference to page number. Again, select the heading you want to refer to. Now the page number is added to the reference. Now that we've added page numbers in the cross-reference, I better add them to the report as well. The easiest way to add page numbers to your document is simply to go to the Insert tab and in the Header and Footer section, select Page Number. Here you can select a nice position and formatting for your page numbers. I'll select to put the page number at the bottom of the page, and I'll select a design with an accent bar and the page number in the right-hand corner. To close the footer, just double-click outside the footer area. By default, the page number is not visible on the first page. Now I'd like to add some document information to the footer. First, I'll open up the footer by just double-clicking it. Instead of just writing the name of our company, I'll use a document field. That way, our company name is added to the properties of the document. To insert a document field, click Document Info and then Document Property. Here, I'll select Company. I'll type in the name of our company, Business Productivity FZ LLC. If you click the File menu and expand the document properties, you can see that our company name has been added to the document information. Next, I want to insert the title of the document. I'll click Document Info and then Document Title. As you can see, it doesn't actually contain the title of the report. Instead of typing in the title here, I want to link it to the title on the first page of the report to make sure it gets updated if someone changes the report title. I'll mark the title, right-click, and select Copy. Next, I'll click Insert, Quick Parts, Document Property, and then I'll select the title property. I'll mark the text in the field holder, right-click, and paste in the title again. As you can see, if I scroll down, the document title field in the footer has been automatically updated. If your report includes tables or images, it's recommended that you insert captions. To insert a caption, mark the image, go to the References tab again, and click Insert Caption. Here, I can choose the label, whether it's a table, figure, or equation. Here, I'll just keep figure. I'll type in a description for the figure. Top 10 smartphone apps in the US 2013, and then click OK. I'll do the same for all the images in the report. Now that I have all of my figures and images in the report marked, I can easily add a list of them. To insert a table of figures, click the References tab and select Insert Table of Figures, and then click OK. A list with links to all your figures in the document will be inserted into your report. Now for the final step. I want to insert a table of contents. To insert a table of contents, go to the page where you want it located. Click the References tab, and then Table of Contents. Here, I'll select the second design. As long as you're using heading styles, the table of contents is automatically populated for you. I want the first paragraph to start on its own page, so I'll go to the Insert tab and click Page Break. Now I have to update the table of contents since everything has shifted. I'll right-click the table of contents, click Update Field, and then Update Entire Table. There, now the report is done. Now it looks much more like a professional report, which will definitely reflect positively on the reader's overall experience of the document.